Dear learners, this is today we are going to discuss about Pearson product moment correlation coefficient. This is part of your course, that is BES 127 assessment for learning. This is module 15. Today we are going to discuss how to calculate Pearson product movement correlation coefficient. And there are many methods, but we will see today two methods, that is Raskor method and the other one is method of deviations from the mean. And in the last session, in the module 15, we have talked about rank difference yesterday, and how to calculate rank difference we have seen when the number of items yeah pairs are 30, then we use rank difference formula. But when we use this Pearson product moment correlation coefficient for Raskor data, and that is why it is called Raskor method, then method of deviations from the mean, it is a simpler way of calculating Pearson product moment correlation coefficient. So let us see. As I said, this is most important and widely used coefficient of correlation developed by Carl Pearson. One is Spearman correlation coefficient, that we have already discussed when we have to calculate when we have rank differences and the items are 30, below 30. But this is used on raw data, and it is also most widely used coefficient of correlation, and it is developed by Carl Pearson. Various techniques are employed to compute this. Today we will discuss two of them, that is Raskor method and method of deviations from the mean. So let us consider the following data, which are scores of 15 students of a class in the subjects of mathematics and science. Hamare paas, we have raw data of students, those have scored in mathematics, 15 students. They are the 15 students and their scores are listed below. And you can see, if for example in mathematics somebody has scored 92, then in science he has scored 85, then in mathematics he has second student 90, then he has scored 82. If the third student has scored 87, 80, so these are the scores of 15 students on maths and science. Then if we have to see, is there any relation between these two subjects, then we compute this product, Pearson product moment correlation coefficient. How to calculate that? Now you see the mathematics scores of 15 students, then science scores of 15 students. Now we find out whether the scoring in mathematics is any way related to scoring in science. To determine this, we must compute the coefficient of correlation using Pearson product moment correlation coefficient. Even if in general also we know that usually those who do in mathematics tend to do good in science also. So that is a by research also it has been proved, the students, those who are good in mathematics, also do good well in science. So whether it is true in this case where the students got 15 students got the scores like this, to find out that is there any relation, if there is any relation, whether again yesterday we have discussed, if there is any relations, the relation will be between minus 1 to 0 to 1. So minus 1 being the negative side and the plus 1 being the positive side, and 0 being the, there is no relationship between the two scores, yeah, two variables. So that we will see. So how to calculate the means of x and y scores. So mean of x scores, for example, sigma x by n, if you add all the scores of mathematics, that is 92 plus 90 plus 87 plus 84 plus 80 plus like that. If you add all these scores, then divided by 15, then it comes to 69. In the similar way, mean scores of Y, if you add on all these scores and divided by the number of students, it comes 63. So mean scores of mathematics is 69 and mean score of Y, that is science, is 63. So how we use that in the to calculate product moment correlation, we have a formula. Before that, we have to compute all these values. If you see the formula being to calculate by RAS score method, we to calculate R correlation coefficient, that is the formula is here, the n root xy minus root x into root y divided by root n x square minus bracket x square, that you can see on the screen. The formula to calculate product moment correlation coefficient, where R is the correlation coefficient, sum of x scores, sum of y scores, sum of sigma x square, that is sum of the squared x scores, sigma y square is sum of the squared y scores, then sigma xy, sum of the products of paired x and y scores. So n is the number of paired scores. Again, this is the formula to calculate product moment coefficient, correlation coefficient. For that, let us see the table. We have put pair to calculate, we need all these data. So let us, x scores are placed like this, and the mean 1035, we have calculated the mean, this is 1035, and divided by 15, mean scores of x is 69, mean scores of y is 63. So the same is presented, this is total of x scores is y is 1035, total of y score is 945, then this is x square, this is squared, then this is y square. In the formula you can see this is sum of the squared x scores. So here you can see the sum of the squared x scores in this column. You can see in the similar way, sum of squared y scores, it is here, then xy. So what is xy? Xy is the sum of products, sum of the products of paired x and y scores. So that is calculated here. You can see here the value of that. Then this is this we will come to the, this is the second formula that we are going to discuss, that is deviation method. This xy, then the second formula we apply these values, but the first formula we have, up to this we have the values, we have calculated x, squared y, then xy. So this, with the help of these values, we will calculate the coefficient of correlation. So let us see how this is the formula to find out the coefficient of correlation by RAS score method. So now let us apply these values in the formula. So this is RAS score method. The correlation coefficient between x and y scores is calculated here. You can see now the formula is R equal to, you can see the formula here. Then we will see, for example, n is number of students, that is 15. Then sigma xy, we will go back and see what is the value of sigma xy. This is here, you have 68013. So let us here we have put sigma xy is 68013. Similarly, minus, this is sigma x, that is 1035. Again you can see y score, that is 945. So if you see, this is 1035 and this is 945. So this we have applied the, we have put these values in the formula. So then you can see the denominator root, again this is n is 15, this is x square, then go back to squared x square. Here you can find out this is x square. So let us put this value in the formula. So this is 74417. In the similar way, minus sum of x scores is 1035, it is squared. Similarly, in the case of n, this is 15, then y square, this is sum of the scores of y, this is, you can see y square is 62203, then you have, we have put it over here, then this is the sum of y scores, that is 945. Once we have placed these values from the table in the formula, then you can see, you can calculate 15 multiplied by 68013 minus 1035. Into 945, we have placed this. When you calculate, you will get the value of, you can root these values. If you calculate, then you get the 42,450.61. When you multiply and put the denominator here, you multiply and put the denominator, and the R value is 0.99. So with this RAS score method, you have we can calculate the coefficient of correlation, that is 0.99. But you can observe that it needs lot of calculations. This is the only difficult part of calculating product moment correlation coefficient by this method. So there is some kind of this kind of, you need to multiply, I think it is square, then multiply, it's a cumbersome exercise. So we have, but still this is, we can calculate R value by this method. But there is another simple method which is called the deviation method. That is what we have, I have said in the beginning. We will compute it in the, we will see today how we calculate coefficient of correlation by these two methods. That is, one is RAS score method, that just now we have seen it. Now we will see method of deviations from the mean. I think this is the simpler one to calculate the same R value. How we will do it? So this is by the same table. Now you can see the deviation method. So deviation method, this is x, this is where somewhere we have taken the mean value, that is mean value we have calculated. If we this is the mean value, this 69 is the mean score of x score. So now let us go to the table. So if you 92, the x score is 92, if you minus that mean score, then it comes to 23. This is x minus x is 69. In this case, 69 minus 92 is 23. Similarly, you can see 69 minus 70, this is 1. Then it is 69 minus 66 is minus 3. Then 69 minus 61 is minus 8. Similarly, so this is, we have each mean, say, each score, when we minus it, these are the values. So this is called a mean deviation. This is mean deviation. Similarly, in the case of y, in the case of y, we have, let us see the mean value of y scores. Mean value of y scores is, that is 63. So let us go to the table and see. Now again, this is y scores. These are y scores, and the mean score is 63. So you minus 63, 85 minus 63 comes to 22, 82 minus 23 comes to 19, 80 minus 63 comes to 17, 76 minus 63 comes to be 13. So you can go here, 55 minus 63 comes to minus 8. So in this way you calculate the from the mean score, you minus the each y score and you have placed it here. So when you calculate, it will be 0 because they are deviations from the mean. So once you got the x mean deviation scores of x scores, then y scores, then you multiply it xy 23 into 22, that is 506, 21 into 19, that is 399, 18 into 17, that is 306. So 15 into 13, this is 195, 11 into 9, 99, 6 into 5, 30, 1 into 3, 3. Similarly, you will multiply all the x, y scores and this will be the, this is the value of the x, y, then you can total it, this is 2808. And similarly, square the x values, x square, then you have y square values. So you square it, each 23 square is 529, 21 square is 441, 18 square is 324, 15 square is 225, 11 square is 121, 6 square is 36, 1 square is 1, 3 square is 9, then 8 square is 64, 9 square is 81, 12 square is 144, 13 square is 169, 13 square is 169, 17 square is 289, 20 square is 400. Similarly, for y scores, 22 square is 484, 19 square is 361, then 70 square is 289, 13 square is 169, 9 square is 81, 5 square is 25, 3 square is 9, 2 square is 4, 8 square is 64, 8 square is 64, 12 square is 144, 13 square is 169, 15 square is 225, 16 square is 256, 18 square is 324. So this way we have calculated the mean values, mean deviation values, then squared it, then multiplied it. You can just see the difference between both the methods. In the first method, we have to compute this cumbersome calculations. It has it runs into thousands, 62, 68 thousand, and it is little difficult to calculate in case the data is more. And you can, if it is the same thing, if we calculate by mean deviation method, there is, we can save time, that is one thing, and it is easy to do the calculation. Now you can see the figures, 2868, so they are manageable. So it is easier when we compare with the raw score method. I think the mean deviation method will be easier. Now let us see, this is for a raw score method. What is the formula for then method of deviation from means? For this, in the above method, calculating the correlation coefficient is laborious, that is what I said, for raw score method to calculate the value of x square, y square and xy, and to find out their sums, it becomes little difficult and takes lot of time. To save time, so that other, the second method is most convenient. Such situations, this method of deviations from the mean of x and y values to compute the Pearson coefficient of correlation, by this method we calculate standard deviation of x scores and y scores. So the formula is sigma xy by n into rho x rho y, that is standard deviation of x scores. Here this is standard deviation of x scores and this is standard deviation of y scores. So this is the formula. Even the formula is simpler than the earlier one. To remember, this will be the easier formula. So let us apply those values in the formula. So standard deviation of x scores, to calculate standard deviation of x scores, for example, now we need x square. So let us go to the table. What is x square in our table? So the x square is, this is 3002. So let us place this in the formula. So the formula is the x square is, this is x square is 3002 and n remains the same, that is number of students, that is 15. So the value of 3002 by 15 comes to be 14.15. In the similar way, we will calculate standard deviation for vice course. The vice course, then again let us see the value of sigma y square. So let us go to the table and find out what is the value of y square. So you can see here the value of y square, this is 2668. So let us place this value in the formula, then you will get this is 2668 by 15, number of students remains same, scores y scores is n15. So this comes to be 13.34. So the next step will be to calculate the, this is the formula for calculating coefficient of correlation coefficient by mean deviation method, that is sigma xy n into standard deviation x, standard deviation y. Substituting the values, we get r equal to, this is sigma xy. Again, let us go back to the table to see the sigma xy value. This is xy and this happens to be 2808. So let us see the value in, let us put the value here, you can see 2808 and n being 15 and then standard deviation of x scores, just you can see this is 14.15. So place 14.15 here. Similarly for y it is 13.34. so just check the standard deviation of y scores, that is 13.34. so now substituting the values, now you have to calculate r sigma xy by n into standard deviation value of x scores and standard deviation value of y score, that is 15 into 14.15 into 13.34. so this comes to be 2808, and when we multiply 15 into this value, then it comes to be again the r is 0.99. so you can just compare the both the methods, we can calculate by both the methods, but you can see the difference between calculating the value by RAS score method and mean deviation method. The value, from the table itself you can observe, this side the scores are like very big numbers, and this you can see the other side little bit manageable numbers. So this is why table remains the same. From the same table we have calculated product moment correlation by RAS score method and also by deviation method, and if you can observe, you can see the value remains the same, 0.99. only the convenience, it is easier to calculate R value by mean deviation method. So this is how we calculate product moment correlation coefficient by both the methods. And from the value of R, this R is 0.99. yesterday we have discussed the R value lies between minus 1 to 1, sometimes minus 1 to 0 to 1, minus 1 being the negative side and plus 1 is the highest. And we have already talked about perfect positive correlation and perfect negative correlation and also no correlation. So in this case the values is 0.99, which means there is very high positive correlation between the scores of maths and science of these 15 students. So the magnitude tells us the strength of relationship. If the value is 10 to 1, then the relationship is very strength is very strong, and the other way also, other way round also, if it is minus side, it is negative. There is no relationship between the these two variables, while the sign suggests the direction. If it is minus, it is negative, and if it is plus, it is positive, and if it is for example plus 1, it is perfect positive relationship. If it is minus 1, it is negative perfect negative relation, and 0 means there is no relation. With the help of these R, we can find out how children score in different subject, what is the relation between scoring pattern of maths and science subject by 15 students. They are more or less they are positively related. So this is how we calculate the Pearson product moment correlation. You can do an activity for practice and do calculate both by raw score method and product the mean deviation method, and you can find the R value. I think with this we have concluded. We have seen discussed in correlation. Yesterday we have discussed rank difference correlation coefficient method. Today we have discussed product moment correlation coefficient methods. Even though there are other methods that we have not discussed, because these two are the most popular methods of calculating coefficient of correlation. Most of the time either rank difference or we will use product moment correlation, even though there are other methods of calculating the coefficient of correlation, which gives us an idea how two variables are related. Thank you.